In this section, we're going to talk about safeguards, approaches, and analyses that are used by the IAEA. Safeguards approaches are basically the process by which the IAEA takes an unsafeguarded facility and applies nuclear safeguards. So if we begin with our unsafeguarded facility, the IAEA concludes some safeguards agreement with the state. Then it takes a look at the facility and examines the facility and the nuclear materials that are being used in the facility and develops its safeguards approach. And then through the safeguards approach, it applies safeguards to the facility, and now you have a safeguarded facility. Safeguards approaches are designed to allow the IAEA to meet safeguards objectives, and they detail the set of safeguards measures chosen for implementation at the nuclear facility. And they must account for the specific type of agreement with the state. If one state has INSERC 66 safeguards agreement with the IAEA and another state has INSERC 153 safeguards agreement, then the safeguards approaches will be different for those different states. In addition to safeguards approaches being different for different states, they can also be different for different facilities within a state. If we take our fictional sovereign state with three nuclear facilities, the IAEA may develop a specific safeguards approach for the first facility that is different from the second facility, which is also different from the third facility. The IAEA can also consider a safeguards approach for the entire state in the case of integrated safeguards. The safeguards approach begins with the signing of a safeguards agreement between the IAEA and the state seeking safeguards. The approach begins with the acquisition of facility information of the facility to be safeguarded, and then the IAEA will establish different safeguards goals for that specific facility and within the specific state. And then it will establish safeguards measures to be implemented at that facility. In developing the safeguards approach, the IAEA must consider both diversion paths and acquisition paths to ensure that the safeguards approach can meet the challenges posed by both diversion paths and nuclear material acquisition paths. So, what do we mean when we say a diversion path? That refers to a nuclear material diversion path, and that is facility specific, and it refers to a hypothetical scheme which a state could consider to divert nuclear materials or to misuse materials or facilities. It is postulated for purposes of developing facility level safeguards approaches, and in developing the safeguards approach, it must be assumed that a diversion path could include one or more concealment methods. The IAEA can analyze its safeguards approach versus the diversion material diversion paths that have been developed. And the purpose of this diversion path analysis is to determine whether a proposed set of safeguards measures would provide sufficient detection capability with respect to a specific diversion path. Once the diversion path analysis is complete in the safeguards approach, the IAEA must consider nuclear material acquisition paths as well. These acquisition paths refer to a hypothetical scheme which a state could consider to acquire nuclear material usable for manufacture of a nuclear explosive device. Now, this could include multiple diversion paths at multiple nuclear facilities. It could also include the use of an undeclared facility or undeclared material. And once all those acquisition paths have been developed, that might include the specific facility within the safeguards approach, then an acquisition path analysis can be done. And the purpose of this acquisition path analysis is to determine whether a proposed set of safeguard measures would provide sufficient detection capability with respect to a specific and all possible acquisition paths. Once both the diversion path analysis and acquisition path analysis have been completed, then the safeguards approach can consider whether the safeguards goals that have been established are being met by the safeguards measures to be employed. If they're not, then the process needs to be restarted and all the analysis reconsidered with a different set of established safeguards measures. However, if they do meet the goals, then the safeguards approach is complete and safeguards can be applied at the given facility.